this afternoon. I was just wondering, God, what are we going to be talking about? And it came strong and it came clear. I told us that each day, God has told us that these 40 days will be for somebody the total deliverance that you need to fulfill your destiny. That's why we advise us not to miss any of the days. And if by whatever reason, for whatever reason you miss, just try and get it back somehow. Just get the CD. Just ensure, God knows the reason why you to miss any of the days, but ensure you don't miss any of the things that will be happening here. And God will help us in Jesus' name. We are going to be talking about deliverance for your home. For your house, that house that you are living in. Deliverance for your home. You know one thing, there are different places in this life. There are different homes in this life. Regardless of how a house looks like, or how a home looks like, the main thing that makes a home blessed is not in the outlook per se. In the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 18, 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 18, the Bible says that we should not look at the things that are physically seen. But because the things that are physically seen, they are temporal. You could look, see a house, very fine. Ah, see the paint of this house, let me go and rent it. And that could be a death trap in these guys. That could be the place that will swallow the person's wealth. The person may not know. So you don't look at the physical, you must always have a spiritual check concerning whatever you want to do. That's why you are children of God. You are spirit first. Why we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen? You don't see demons per se. You don't even see angels that could be in the earth. The things that are not seen, for the things which are seen are temporal. The pain will fade away. But the things which are not seen are what? Eternal. They can affect a person's destiny eternally. Many homes need deliverance. many homes. There are, broadly speaking, two types of homes in this life, or two types of places in this life. Blessed place or blessed home and cursed home. There are some blessed people that are living in cursed houses. I'm telling you, and it's affecting them, but they don't know. In the book of Deuteronomy chapter 30 verse 19, God himself was speaking broadly that there are two types of things, the blessed and the cursed. The one that brings life and the one that brings death. I call heaven and earth to record this day against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessing and curses. Therefore, do what? Choose life, that both thou, not only you, and the people that are around you may live. There are some homes that are blessed. In those homes, the transaction there is heavenly. Good spirits flow in and out of those homes. There was a time that Jacob was traveling and he slept at a particular location. Guess what he did that he had? He saw angels going up and down and God at the pinnacle. And the voice of God was just saying, there are some homes like that, open heavens. In the book of Genesis chapter 28, you see that 11 to 17. Genesis 28, 11 to 17. And he lighted upon a place, a certain place, and tarried there all night, because the sun was set. And he took of the stones of that place, and put them for his pillows, and lay down in that place to sleep. And he dreamed. And behold, a ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached to heaven. And behold, the angel of God ascending and descending on it. And behold, the Lord stood above it and said, I am the Lord God of Abraham, thy father, and the God of Isaac. The land whereon thou liest, to thee will I give it, and to thy seed. And thy seed shall be as the dust of the earth, and thou shalt spread abroad to the west, and to the east, and to the north, and to the south. And in thee, and in thy seed shall all the families of the earth be blessed. 15. And behold, I am with thee, and will keep thee in all places, whither thou goest, and will bring thee again into this land. For I will not leave thee until I have done that which I have spoken to thee of. 16. Where we are going. And Jacob awake out of his sleep. And he said, what did he say?
Surely
the Lord is in this place, and I knew it not. 17. And he was afraid, and said, how dreadful is this place? This is none other but the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. Praise the Lord. There are some houses that are like that. Every transaction is very easy. Blessings flow in, and there are some houses that are houses of bondage. In the book of Exodus chapter 13, verse 14, you will see that they said house of bondage. Some people are living in the house of bondage. That's why they find things hard. If you are living in any house of bondage, let the bondage that is in that house be destroyed.
Amen.
Let that house be converted to the house of blessing.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Exodus 13, 14 and 15. And it shall be, when thy sons ask thee in time to come, saying, what is this that thou shalt say unto him? By strength of hand the Lord brought us out of Egypt. From where? From the house of bondage. And it came to pass, when Pharaoh would hardly let us go, that the Lord slew all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, both the firstborn of man and the firstborn of beast. Therefore I sacrifice to the Lord all that opened the matches, being male, but all the firstborn of my children I redeem. Praise the Lord. There are some houses that are blessed houses, there are some houses that are cursed houses. And those cursed houses, that they are houses of bondage. People will have six cars, they will enter into those houses. At the end of the day, when they will be going, they will be trekking. There are some houses like that. People will enter into it. By the time you will be leaving that house, somebody has died in the family, another person has died so many years after, is the house that, just like the Israelites, when they went to spy the land of Canaan, they gave us a revelation in that Numbers chapter 13, I think 32 or 33. He said that the land that we have gone is a good land, but it's the land that eateth up these inhabitants. Meaning that there are some land that eat up, and some houses are built on such location. Very important. When we were growing up, okay, and they brought up an evil report of the land, which they had searched unto the children of Israel, saying, the land or the house through which we have gone to search it is a land or house that eateth up the people that are living there. Every house that you are in that is a coffin in the realm of the spirit, let the fire of God consume that coffin. In the name of Jesus Christ. When we're going up, there used to be a TV, well, not TV, it was not a series, but those days, film were not really, or movie were not really so much around that you could just purchase. So we used to depend on TV to show us Indian films. And Chinese film. There will be time for Chinese film, time for Indian film. Then horror films, usually at night, they used to believe that maybe we the children will accept. But some of us, especially when our parents will travel, we say we must watch all, because this will give us, I think, preview during the day of what will happen. Come and see. We didn't really understand, but it just to tell us that there are some houses that are cursed. You see a typical kind of horror film like this. The windows are closed, the doors are closed. You just be seeing the blind. Where is no fan is on, oh no. The blind will just be broke. Sometimes the door will just open by the you know? The only, everybody will just. And sometimes somebody will look at the mirror, the person will be checking the mirror, and we see somebody inside the mirror, we will look, but we will not see. You know, different things. And for one, we children that time, he said, who sent us to go and watch this? We'll be shaking. We'll be watching something, we'll be shaking. If somebody mistaken, he's talking like, hey! He said, why are you talking to me now? Is it talk has become another thing? You know, I don't want to tell you, so next time don't talk to me like that now. You don't need to fear. But just to tell us that they are called and all those people, sometimes we'll just be looking at them. That decides that somebody will not enter the house. We'll be seeing some strange things. Say, hello, is somebody there? Is somebody there? If it's in the year, you see one sign like this. You know? Because they want to be finding out. They'll be entering. You think I think, come on, away. That's when they want to enter. Praise the Lord. But just to tell us that they are caused. Houses that people enter into. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father,
Father,
adventure I am in a cursed house.
Or
an evil covenanted house. Deliver me. And destroy that covenant in that house. In the name of Jesus. Deliver me. And destroy whatever covenant that is leaving me now. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Let your house be divinely sanctified. There's some houses. Prayer is hard for prayer to be answered. Prayers are in there because of the forces that are there. A pure man, is prayer got in there? Who are you? Are you as pure as that? It's just for you to know some things in the realm of the spirit. That's why this 40 days, God wants to deliver us totally so that our speed of achievement will be so great.
Amen.
In Daniel chapter 10, 12 to, I think 14. Daniel 10, 12 to, he prayed. The whole Daniel prayed for 21 days. He did not receive. You know that he was not a sinner. To tell you that some people could be praying in their houses, not that they will not receive it, but they receive things slowly. And assuming the houses that they are living in happen to be pure, by the next day, they'll be getting results. They'll be getting things, but not that they don't get, they get things, but they get things hardly. They pray so much, they do vigils, they do, get to them, say that, even I'm praying, it's not even equal to what I'm receiving. Maybe that house has something. Then said he unto me, fear not, Daniel, for from the first day that thou didst set thy heart to understand and to chasten thyself before thy God, thy words were heard. God has heard, says, and I have come for thy words. But there are forces over that particular terrain that he was in, over that house that he was in. The prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 120 days. But lo, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me, and I remained there. Somebody's blessing that God has already released, but forces contending for that blessing to be released to the person, to get to the person. Now I am come to make thee understand What shall befall thy people in the latter days? For yet division is for many days. He had prayed. The angel was telling the very first day that you prayed it, that you made that to pray, God had answered. And he has sent me. But there are forces, there are houses that the prayer that they make there, those prayers are being hindered. And as all other houses, when they pray in such houses, they give testimony per moment. Just like the one that Jacob, you know, when he saw transaction, angels going up the ladder, coming down. What are they doing? Whenever they are going up, they are going with the prayer requests, and they are coming down with the answer. Going with it, he's just very busy. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father,
let my house,
the one that I live in,
be sanctified,
and let there be a godly transaction of heaven in the name of Jesus Christ. Let there be a traffic of heaven. Let angels be on the queue. They will say, let me pass. I want to go and deliver my own message. You are waiting. Let it just be angelic traffic. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we all pray. I pray that your out every anti-answer to your prayer demons that is in that your house, let the Almighty God crush them.
Amen.
Let them out of your house.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There are some houses that prayers are answered with ease. There was a particular time that they were praying in a house for Peter. Peter was in the prison. He was still praying. Peter was knocking on the door. The house that you will be praying, that the object of the answer is getting to you even faster than you are even expecting, that will be your house from today.
Amen.
In the book of Acts chapter 12:12-16, you see that there. Let's read it. Acts chapter 12:12-16. And when he had considered the thing, that Peter, he came to the house of Mary, the mother of John, whose surname was Mark, where many were gathered together. What were they doing?
Pray.
They are praying for him, because the church was praying for him. And as Peter knocked at the door of the gate, a dancer came to Achim, named Rhoda. And when she knew Peter's voice, she opened up the gate for gladness, but ran in and told how Peter stood before the gate. And they said unto her, thou art mad. They could not believe that we are praying for somebody. How can you say that the person has just come? Thou art mad. But she constantly affirmed that it was even so. Then said they, it is his angel. But Peter continued knocking. And when they had opened the door and saw him, they were open your mouth and pray and say, Father, let my house be the house that prayers will be answered in an amazing way from now on. In the name of Jesus. Make my house the house that prayer will be answered quickly. Let my house be the house that prayer will be answered quickly. By the time I'm praying, before I even finish prayer, there will be results. My phone will be ringing for the result. Text message will be coming in for the result. Knock will be on my door for the result of the prayer that will be praying in my house for now. Thank you, brother. In Jesus' mighty name, we all pray. Every demon that has been hindering your prayers, let the power and the blood of Jesus Christ arrest them.
Yeah.
Flush them out of your home.
Yeah.
And let there be easy transportation of your blessing from heaven to your life in the name of Jesus. So shall it be.
Yeah.
In Jesus' name. Yeah. There are some homes that the home is so blessed that what they are not even asking for flows to them. Blessings that they don't, you know, homes, cost, They are praying. Argo forces are hindering you. Another one. They are praying and they are getting what they are praying exactly as they are praying. But another one. They are praying, they are getting. But in addition to that, what they are not even asking for is being brought, and no force is in doing it. Luke chapter 1, 26 to 28, Mary the Virgin. She did not even pray for that. But the angel of the Lord appeared, entered into her house, and said, God has sent me to you. He said, I didn't pray for a car. I didn't pray for this visa. I didn't pray for this clothes. I didn't pray for... there is a house that a person can live in. That blessing that you are not even asking. That is what God said, that he's able to do exceeding what? Abundantly above. Not just what you ask, it below. God wants to give you what you don't ask, that the thing that will glorify his name in your life. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, and of the house of David. This particular house was a blessed house, very blessed house. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her inside the house, not even outside. Go and call Mary for me. No, the angel came in into the house. And unlike Daniel, no prince of earth, no force was in it. And said, "Hail, thou that art highly favored. The Lord is what?
With thee.
Is with thee. Blessed art thou among women." She received the gift of a baby boy that she was not asking for. Daniel, a blessed man, was being hindered. Many blessed people are living in cursed houses. That is the truth of what is happening right now in this life, in this our generation. Because many people are careless about it. They don't move into the excitement of moving into a new house makes people to be careless spiritually. There are some false resident demons that are in some places now. Before you go there, it's not about the finance of the place. So there are some spiritual things that must be done. And if the foundation be destroyed, if you are not taking time to do those things, many things will now start coming. But I'm praying that as God is opening us to all this, many of these things I did not know until this afternoon. I'm telling you, I know that the thing that we'll be receiving fresh from heaven. I pray that any of our houses that is avoiding any demon that is injuring our blessing, the Almighty God shall arise.
Amen.
I say that the Almighty God shall arise.
Amen.
There are some houses that the power, the demon, the spirit that are abiding in those houses, they reduce people's profits. Their salary, they will get fine. They will get the money, but they can't account for it. It will be lost. Those are the forces. You know, in the land of Egypt, in those days, when Pharaoh was there and Joseph was the prime minister, there was a law. The law was that they would tax 20%, that is one fifth, 20% of everybody, whatever house that you are living in, except the land of Goshen. There are some houses that are Goshen houses. All around, when you look at our first time, every house seems the same, but it's a lie. There are some houses that are Goshen, and there are some that are like Egypt. They are being taxed. They get so much in salary, in profit, but they can't account for much because the power that are there will reduce it. In the book of that Genesis 47 verse 26, Genesis 47 26, and Joseph made it a law over the land of Egypt unto this day that Pharaoh should have the fifth part, that's 20%. Except the land of the priests only, which became not Pharaoh. Inside the same Egypt, different laws operated. God has even said it, that he can make rain to fall on one part of the city and spare the other part of the city. So, in a particular close, there are blessed houses, there are heavily blessed houses, there are lightly blessed houses, there are cursed houses, there are heavily cursed houses. I'm praying that whichever one that your own is that is not in conformity with you as a blessed person, let there be a transformation.
Amen.
Let there be a transformation.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There are some houses that people move into. They move into the spirit that are already abiding. No, those spirits, they are because something abided. When you have a computer and it just goes like dark, you are not putting it off. It is still on. When you touch any key, it will not come on. Spirits hibernate. The eye, it is sometimes they don't raise their own head. There are some houses that the spirit, the power that are inside those houses that people pack into, they just find pain, they just prepare cook good money. It does not matter, it's not about the money, it's about the spiritual part of that house. And they enter into it, there is always conflict in that house. Because there are some houses that then they must be divided. There are factions in the house. The thing that is just happening, they don't know that they are just coming to the spirit that is controlling them. There are some houses that there is hostility, the kind of hostility, they can't even understand it. They just operate it. There are some houses that they have hatred, evil siblings, spouses. It's because we have been ignorant, even blessed people. Blessed people are living in closed houses. That was God was telling me this afternoon. I was shocked. I now took time to start listening to the classroom that he took me, one after the other. In the book of Mark chapter 3, 25. Mark chapter 3, 25. Mark said that a house that was that is divided against itself. What will happen? That house cannot stand. So that is the aim of the devil. He has spirits that will make hostility, malice, grudges just going inside the house. And the people think that they are just fighting each other. But they should not be deceived that there are powers that are, they are living with. They are doing every other thing, but those powers are in control. You must not take possession. That's why God will tell the people those things. Say that when you get to the land, drive out every. God knows that there are always people already on the land. Say that drive out all the America, spare no one. But spiritually, in this our modern day, do we take. That's why the Bible says that my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. But thank God, God is calling us apart in KLP to start giving us deep understanding of some spiritual things. So that when we stand, we are standing tall and no evil can harass us.
Amen.
Because there ought to be unity in the home for there to be blessings. And the devil will bring disunity. Otherwise they will be fighting each other. They will be thinking it because there will be a reason. But that reason is unfounded, it is not really reason. There is a spirit behind. There was a particular time that Peter was jacking Jesus Christ for rebuking him. I said he was right. But Jesus Christ looked at him. He said that Satan, get thee what?
Behind me.
You will say that is this guy that was rebuking him. Right, that he rebuked him sharply that he would not go and die. But he was able to see beyond the physical that he's not this guy. There's a force that is moving him to do this thing that he just did. It's not him. And he was able to speak. And I told him, I'll pray for you. It is very important. Because when a house is united, in the book of Psalm 133, verse 1, Psalm 133, verse that, behold, how good is it for brethren to dwell together where? In unity. Behold, how good and how pleasant. The devil does not want that one. So you will have planted the spirit of division, the spirit of hostility, the spirit of hatred. There, you will just pack in, you will just clean the house, you know, change the tiles, you know, praying some shifu prayer and think that the devil have gone. But we'll be delivered from all the powers in our hopes that have been terrorizing our lives. No, let me read. How pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Go to verse 3. Verse 3 is where I'm actually going. As the dew of Ammon and as the dew that descended upon the mountain of Zion. For where? For there the Lord commanded the blessing. Even what? How did it start from verse 1? Said that when brethren dwell together in unity, just the natural Lord different story, that's that there, in that place of unity, in that oh, there the Lord has commanded the blessing. Devil knows that one. Say that spirit of hostility come into this home so that there the Lord has commanded the blessing, they will not be seeing the blessing. Instead of life in their health, life in their finances, life in their marriage, they will not be seeing life, they will be seeing opposite. So, but when the spirits are driven out, you don't find it easy to be tolerant. It will not be coming to you easy. You will find it easy to let go. Why? Because those spirits have been taken care of. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, every spirit of hostility, of hatred
in my home,
by the power and the blood of Jesus, be flushed out now in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of division, disunity in my home, by the power and the blood of Jesus, Be flushed out. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name be on prayer. Every spirit that I've been bringing division, misrepresentation, misunderstanding, bitterness, hatred into your home, wherever your home may be, I don't care. Let the blood of Jesus flush them out. And let the spirit of the living God, the spirit of love, the spirit of joy, the spirit of peace, the spirit of progress flood your home now. In Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. There are some homes that they are spirit of barrenness, spirit of anti-productivity happening there. And the thing that happened to them, they're not just ordinary, not just from their father's side per se, their mother's side, but it's the house that they have gone into, cause house. Some people say until they change the house. Before that week they are looking for will not come. That is if they will not be strong enough to destroy the thing in the house. In the book of 2 Kings chapter 2, 19 to 22, in 2 Kings chapter 2, 19 to 22, there was a time they called Elisha and said that we can see the facade of this house, the elevation, the front elevation, it's pleasant. But the things that are happening there, the environment, there is no productivity. Financially, we are struggling, no product. We are doing much in this home, but we are not getting any result. And the man of the season said to Elisha, behold, I pray thee, the situation of this city is pleasant. As my Lord see it, that's what you are saying. But the water is not, and the ground barren. And he said, bring me a new cruse and put salt therein. And they brought it to him. And he went forth to the spring of the waters, that to the root, and cast the salt in there, and said, thus saith the Lord, I have healed these waters. There shall not be from thence any more what? Death or barren land. And that was exactly how it was. There are some houses like that. The spirits that the people they passed into, even though they are believers, but by the time they were packing into the houses, they were not really strong believers. And those things, they came to meet those things, and they did not really try them out. He just prayed too. So something could have gone out, but there are some houses like that are like that. There was a particular, I think I've told this story before. Wherever there is the house of violence, there will be miscarriages. There will be so many things, not just in the foot of the womb, but even business, almost dead businesses. It could be that the spirit of violence is operating in that home. There is this particular couple, they kept up, actually they will bring forth, but the children were dying. The babies, not even children, babies, because they're not even up to 1 month, 2 months, they will die. 1 month, 2 months, they will die. This man of God, who happened to be their family friend, came to the city to minister and chose to stay with them, you know, to go from their home to minister. So by the time he was praying to go and minister, you know, he was just praying, but he was struggling in the realm of the spirit. So there's something that's hindering this. Whenever I pray, I know by now I will just feel it with you. I'm already connected to heaven. But I'm finding it is hard to even connect. Something is in the house. I told the friend, I don't know what you mean. So let me go for my ministration. When I come back, we'll talk about that. Actually, he went for the ministration. When he came back, they just said, they said, okay, what were you talking about? He said, okay, do you permit me to pray around the house? So go ahead. And he went from one room to another. I was just praying, marching, Lord, just show me what is this thing that is in me. I'm not feeling free in this place. And he prayed anyway. He now told me, I can't get my hand on anything. I don't know. But it's only your master bedroom that I've not entered into. You and your wife allow me, why not enter now? And he entered and he started, not long as he started praying, he just saw the baby cut. He saw an aged woman just moving around the cut. In the name of the spirit, he said, what a beautiful coffin. What a beautiful coffin. What a beautiful coffin. I said that this is the problem. He said, what is it? God, well, they are not saying anything. He said that every baby you put into this cut will always die. You see, like mother care that they go to some. Whether it is other care. This thing, he said, we bought this from the shop when you travel. This thing is cursed. They now took it away. I think they destroyed it. They now went to Baba Sube with care. They called the local carpenter, built cursed for us. She conceived, delivered, the baby lived. There are some people that have cursed items in their home. There are some homes that the building materials are cursed because they are blood money. How will you know now? How will you be saved now? The building materials, they are cursed money. Somebody killed and the blood is speaking against the people that are inside those homes. At a particular time, the Israelites, they were beating Syria. And Joshua was annoyed. He went to God. Why did you do this? He said that stolen items have been part of what's formed your stuff. He said, stolen items. Say yes. And they are cursed things among what is in your house. That is why you are losing your battle. You are losing your battle financially. You are losing the pot. You are losing anyway. Because there are some things that ought not to be in your own. Any item that you are not even aware of that has entered into your home, that has made that home to be tied in the realm of the spirit, a called home, let that item catch fire in the realm of the spirit. In the book of Joshua chapter 7, 11 and 12, you will see what God was telling him there. Joshua 7, 11 and 12. Some houses that have caused, or with stolen material, building materials that they use, or stolen money or blood money that they use. And they now said, agent, please, can you help me to rent this flat, this decay, this, but which money? Is Israel have sinned and they have also transgressed my covenant, which I commanded them. For they have even taken of the accursed thing, and have also stolen, and dissembled also, and they have put it even what? Among their own stuff. Therefore, you know the reason why many people are defeated in monetary, financially, in their health, it could be that they are living in a cursed house. Therefore, the children of Israel could not, God was speaking, not the prophet, stand before their enemies, but turn their backs before their enemies, because they were accursed. Neither will I be with you anymore, except what happened? He destroyed the accursed. That is the reason why God has called us today. He loves us. He wants the Lord to keep us, to keep on suffering from just praying, and we are not really seeing the full effect of our prayer. And he's looking for me. I want to hear. Joshua was even like he tried to intimidate God. How come they said that you call on you and you are not even answering me because I'm praying so much prayer. I'm not even seeing. You don't know many things. Anytime you are accusing me, I can never be wrong. Always ask me, what is it that I am doing wrongly or I'm yet to do? Or just show me what I need to do. And he now told him that he did not know that he can or anybody had done anything. That is the reason. I pray for you that any else that you may be living in that could be accursed one way or the other, or any item that has come into your house, maybe you did not even take it into the house, but somebody brought it from somewhere that you did not know, and it can bring a problem into your house, let the fire of God locate that item. Let the cursed spirit that has been attached to that item be banished from your home. So shall it be. However, there are some people that outrightly they need to relocate. Outrightly. God can actually bring deliverance. But some, for what one reason or the other, that I don't know why God allows that, he will just say, relocate. It happened to Abraham. Abraham, Genesis chapter 12, 1 and 2. Genesis 12, 1 and 2. Abraham, sir, live where you are. Ah, it's my family. Live where you are. If you don't live, blessing will not come, your name will not be great too. But when you live, I will, because you're a blessed man in a cursed house. How do you reconcile that? Even when you are getting blessings, the blessing that you are getting is less than hateful. Even though you are religious every day, testimony. If only you knew what you would have been getting if you are living in a blessed house. You will not be rejoicing. You will be crying. You mean I could have been getting all these things, but the prince of Persia, the forces that are in this house, they are limiting the blessing. Now the Lord has said unto Abraham, get thee out of the country and from thy kindred, and from thy father's house unto a land that what? I will show thee. Two. And I will make thee. God, make me where I am. Forget, I understand why. Get thee out of that place first. And I will make thee a great nation. And I will bless thee. And make thy name great. And thou shalt be what?
Be
a blessing. God told me clearly this afternoon, many of my blessed children are living in cursed houses. I was such. Many of these things I've told you, I didn't know before, I didn't know them that deep. As I was telling you, well, now each point it would give me, it would now back it up to the speaker. Now I'm going, it's true. You give me another point, check it in. It's true. So that is exactly what has been happening. Oh, there is somebody else that brought the CD into the household, but how that CD, it will be a consumer and it's affecting them, but they're not taking time. They pray for everything, but they just neglect to pray and to deliver where they are. But God, in His mercy, has designed that today we will deal with that.
Amen.
Shall we rest our feet? Let's rest our feet. Let's rest our feet. Rest our feet. When you live in a blessed house and you are a blessed person, I tell you, it will be so evident that you are a blessed person. It will be evident. People will see it clearly. They don't, you don't need to be telling them. You know, there are some people who is not until they testify. You see clearly that this person is blessed. And by the time you are entering into a place, you know, I've even discovered that I have not even prayed effectively concerning house dedication. It's today that God made me to realize that. It was the most important thing. Just say, don't get out like that. He said that you will mention some things and not able to prepare. I think about 34 of your album. That this is just will be a typical prayer for you to be doing in the house. And when the house is blessed, it doesn't mean that it's just blessed forever like that. And I said that tell them that they should not be mindful of who they allow to enter and the things that they bring inside. That it will also pollute a blessed house. He was telling me that this afternoon, that even if it's a family member, let them pray and be led before whoever that comes in to stay with them will come. Let's open our mouth and pray and say, Father, thank you for this fresh insight
you are
giving to me in order to bring deliverance to me and my family. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for this fresh insight you have given it to me in order to bring deliverance to me and my family. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. These are the prayer points that he gave me. And when he gave me, I took time to pray it inside my house. As he was giving me, I was thanking him for, God, thank you for making me to sit in the way I'm seeing it now. Then number two, say, Father, please have mercy on me. And cleanse me of all unrighteousness. That could cause my prayer to be hindered. That could cause my prayer not to be answered or to be hindered. Let's pray that to be reformed. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. We are come to discover or to establish that there are blessed houses and there are cursed houses. There are blessed places, there are cursed places. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, please. Order my step to the places of blessings and not cursed places, always in the name of Jesus. Father, order my steps to the places of blessings and not cursed places, always. When I'm looking for a help, let me never be led to a one that will be a cursed house. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Jacob saw the traffic of heaven. Angels going up and down. What a good traffic. Come, I'm bringing my own blessing. Oh, let me put you down. What a good traffic. Say, Father.
Father.
Please let there be positive heavenly traffic of good angels bringing blessings to my own efforts in the name of Jesus. Let there be positive heavenly traffic of good angels bringing blessings for my own henceforth. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please make the place I live a place of quick answer to prayers in the name of Jesus. They were praying for Peter. Peter was already knocking on the door. Make the place that I live a place of quick answer to our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, please clear off my home. Every prayer hindering demon. And let blessing flow unto us with ease. Father, every prayer hindering demon. It was hindering Daniel's prayer. Every prayer hindering demon in my home, be cleared off now in the name of Jesus. And let blessing flow without hindrance into our home from now on. miracle. In Jesus' mighty name, we all pray. Joseph was talking about taxing everything that was coming into their house. 20 be said, open your mouth and pray and say, Father, banish from my home. Every prosperity or power taken. Or every power that is taken. Or reducing my income. Anytime I receive it in the name of Jesus. Banish from my home every spirit of power that is taking or reducing my income. Anytime I receive it. Banish from my home every power that is taking or reducing my income. Anytime I receive it. Do some nonsense means. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. He said that it's your own, they will just be fighting, there will be faction in the home, there will be hatred, the kind of hatred that you don't even understand, there will be a spirit, the spirit that is already in that home, that they have not conducted deliverance when the young woman that they into that home. Say, Father, please drive out of my home right now. Every spirit of division, hatred, hostility, and malice in the name of Jesus. Of my own right now, every spirit of division, hatred, hostility, and malice, call it out of my own. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. We have said that when the spirits leave and they find a place clean, they will not come back. So we will fill our home. Say, Father, we fill my home with your spirit of love. Joy, peace, and great blessings in the name of Jesus. Father, fill my home with your spirit of love, joy, peace, and great blessings. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. We talk about the spirit of barrenness or anti-productivity spirit. And they now to call the man of God Elisha. He now said, it's not ordinary. And he now took Saul and it was healed and there was no more death. That means that there are some houses that death will always be in their finances, in their health, in their whatever. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, please drive out of my home. Every spirit of barrenness. Sickness, miscarriage, and anti-productivity power. With the middle of the mess, drive it down, drive it down, drive it down. Every spirit of violence, every spirit of sickness, every spirit of anti-productivity, every spirit of miscarriage. With the middle of the mess. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. If it is video recorder that happened to be bewitched, they will be delivered today. Yeah. If it is in doorknob that you bought, that somebody stole it and now released it to you, and somebody that it was stolen from across that particular thing, every one of them will be delivered. Yeah. Was clothing that you bought and a person went to steal the clothing, broke into somebody's shop and now brought it into another city and you now brought it and it now becomes a cult item in your home that you use your money, it will be delivered. Hey, hey, hey. Every bewitched item in my home, bringing misfortune, sickness, or retrogression by the power of the Most High God, be bound and cast out now in the name of Jesus. Every bewitched item that is bringing misfortune, sickness, retrogression, by the power of the Most High God, be bound and cast out. Be bound and cast out. Thank you, God. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. All these things happen in the realm of the spirit, because you may not even know which is which, but by the time you pray, God will remove them, but we are going to say that God should be replacing them with the blessed one in the realm of the spirit, so that those things will not have any mark of being caused again. Say, Father, by your outstretched hand, please remove every cause of stolen item from my home and divinely replace the blessed ones from heaven in the name of Jesus. By your hands, Satan, remove every cursed item from our home and divinely replace with the blessed ones from heaven. Divinely replace with the blessed ones from heaven. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please cleanse my own spiritually, mentally, physically, with the blood of Jesus. From the foundation to the roof, in the name of Jesus. Father, cleanse my own spiritually, mentally, physically, from the foundation to the roof, with the blood of Jesus. Cleanse my own. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please let the fire of the Holy Spirit engulf my entire home and make it inhabitable to any unclean spirit or evil spirit in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost engulf my entire home and make my home inhabitable to any unclean spirit, any evil spirit. Let them not be able to inhabit in our home again. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please send your angels, as you did in the time of the Garden of Eden, to continually guard my home and keep away evil forces. Father, send your angels, as you did in the time of the Garden of Eden, to continually guard my home, as you did in the time of the Garden of Eden. Let them keep away evil forces. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please convert every cursed wall or building material in my home to bless ones by your mercy and power. Every cursed wall, every cursed nail, every cursed wood, anything that they were using in the building construction that have been caused that I did not know, Father, convert them to blessed ones. Let every word be blessed. Every item, every building item in my home, let them become blessed. Now, in Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I mentioned some of us have been contaminated by the release of these spirits that we came to live or live with inside. I will say by the power and the blood of Jesus. By the power of the Most High God, I purify my spirit, soul, and body, and that of all members of my home, with the blood of Jesus. By the power of the Most High God, I purify my spirit, soul, and body, and that of every member of my home, with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please take out by your consuming fire enemy residing in my home, in any realm with immediate effects. Turn them out. Whether in the spirit, turn them out. Even if they are physical, turn them out. Every enemy. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, let every monitoring device of the kingdom of darkness in my home be utterly destroyed right now in the name of Jesus. Every monitoring device, even if it is a wall gecko, that is a monitoring device. If it is a cobweb, that is a wall monitoring device. And if it is a mosquito, that is any monitoring device, stylishly put it on my home, destroyed by fire. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, every demonic network in my home, I begin by the power of the Most High God, scatter the fire. Every demonic network in my home, scatter the fire. Every demonic network that is in my home. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, every evil altar in my home, I'm trapping the money presence and repelling God's presence. name. That fire be destroyed. Every wood altar in our home. Attracting the money present and repelling God's presence. That fire be destroyed. That fire be destroyed. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Okay, by the power of the Most High God, I command all evil gates into my house to be destroyed. And the opening be sealed with the blood of Jesus. Every evil gate into my house be destroyed. And let the opening be sealed with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Say, I command by the power of the Most High God that every demon assigned to my home should go back to the senders and carry out the assignment with immediate effect there in the name of Jesus. Every demon that will be assigned to my home, go back to the sender and carry out that assignment there. Carry out your assignment there in the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, please paralyze and expose every human agent of the devil in my house and flush them out with immediate effect. Every human agent of the devil in my house, paralyze, expose, flush out. Paralyze, expose, flush out. Paralyze, expose, flush out. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, please take down all demons attached to any equipment or item in my home. And let those equipment become blessed. Every demon that is attached to any equipment or item, any demon attached to my kitchen utensils, attached to my TV, attached to any item in my home, flush out and let those items become blessed. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Okay, Father, please cut asunder and destroy any satanic padlock, cage, webs used against the prosperity and good health of anyone in the home. Father, cut asunder and destroy any satanic padlock, any cage, any webs used against the prosperity and good health of anyone in the home. Cut them asunder wherever they are. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, please let the blood of Jesus speak to nullify any curse existing in our home. And let blessing be pronounced in the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus Christ can speak. Let the blood of Jesus Christ speak to nullify any curse that is in my home, in that place that I'm living. Let the blood of Jesus Christ speak and nullify any curse that is inside that my house. And let blessing be pronounced now. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Say, by the power of the Most High God, I remove my name and that of any member of my home from any evil register of affliction from any place right now in the name of Jesus. I remove my name and the name of any member of my home from any register of affliction. Right now I remove our names. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Say, Father, by the power in the blood of Jesus, I break any satanic covenant made by the builders, landlord, or the owner of the house that I live in the name of Jesus. Every satanic covenant that will be made by my man and my landlord, by the builders, by any owner of the property that I live, I break it, break it, break every satanic covenant of that place that I'm living. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Say, by the power in the blood of Jesus, I break any soul ties, I or any member of my home, to have be any residing demon in that home in the name of Jesus. Any soul tie that I have with the residing demon in that home or any member of my own house, I break that soul tie now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Number 31 out of 34. Say, Father, please release the power of resurrection on me and my family members. And let every deadness come alive gloriously. Release the power of resurrection upon me and every member of my own. Let every deadness come alive now gloriously. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Number 32 out of 34. Say, by the power of the Most High God, I command the fire of God to enter every nook and cranny of my own and destroy any charm that have been buried with immediate effect. Let the fire of God enter every nook and cranny of my own. Look at any charm that have been buried inside the wall, in the ceiling. Let the fire of God destroy every charm that have been buried in my home. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Number 33 is the fire. Please bless my home. And let blessings that money can buy and the one money cannot buy flood my home from this moment in the name of Jesus. Bless my home and let money, the blessings that money can buy and the one money cannot buy flood my home from this moment. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Number 34, finally, say, Father, thank you for the mighty deliverance. You have wrought in my home right now. Be glorified forever.
Appreciate the name of Jesus. Bless his holy name. Father, we thank him for the mighty deliverance. Who could have done this for us? Who could have opened our eyes to see this?
Lord, that's the root. I cast the sword in there and said, thus saith the Lord, I have healed these waters. There shall not be from thence any more what? Death or barren land. And that was exactly how it was. There are some houses like that. The spirits that the people they passed into, even though they are believers, but by the time they were packing into the houses, they were not really strong believers. And those things, they came to meet those things, and they did not really try them out. They just prayed through. So something could have gone out, but there are some houses like that are like that. There was a particular, I think I've told this story before. Wherever there is the house of violence, there will be miscarriages. There will be so many things, not just in the foot of the womb, but even business, almost dead businesses. It could be that the spirit of violence is operating in that home. There is this particular couple, they kept up, actually they will bring forth, but the children were dying. The babies, not even children, babies, because they're not even up to 1 month, 2 months, they will die. 1 month, 2 months, they will die. This man of God, who happened to be their family friend, came to the city to minister and chose to stay with them, you know, to go from their home to minister. So by the time he was praying to go and minister, you know, he was just praying, but he was struggling in the realm of the spirit. So there's something that's hindering this. Whenever I pray, I know by now I will just feel the relief. I'm already connected to heaven. But I'm finding it is hard to even connect. Something is in the app. I told his friend, he said, I don't know what you mean. So let me go for my ministration. When I come back, we'll talk about that. Actually, he went for the ministration. When he came back, they just said, they said, okay, what we're talking about. Is that okay? Do you permit me to pray around the house? So go ahead. And he went from one room to another, I was just praying, marching, Lord, just show me what is this thing that is in me. I'm not feeling free in this place. And he prayed anyway. He now told me, I can't get my hand on anything, I don't know. But it's only your master bedroom that I've not entered into. You and your wife allow me, why not enter now? And he entered and he started, not long as he started praying, he just saw the baby cut. He saw an aged woman just moving around the cut. In the name of the Spirit, said, what a beautiful coffin. What a beautiful coffin. What a beautiful coffin. I said that this is the problem. I said, what is it? Go help, they are not saying anything. I said that every baby you put into this cut will always die. You see that it's mother care that they go to some. You know that it is other care. This thing, you know, we bought this from the shop when we travel. This thing is cursed. They now took it away. I think they destroyed it. They now went to Baba Subehu care. They called the local carpenter, built cursed for us. She conceived, delivered, the baby lived. There are some people that have cursed items in their home. There are some homes that the building materials are cursed because they are blood money. How will you know now? How will you be saved now? The building materials, they are cursed money. Somebody killed and the blood is speaking against the people that are inside those homes. At a particular time, the Israelites, they were beating Syria. And Joshua was annoyed. He went to God. Why did you do this? He said that stolen items have been part of what's from your stuff. He said, stolen items. Say yes. And there are cursed things among what is in your house. That is why you are losing your battle. You are losing your battle financially. You are losing the court. You are losing anyway. Because there are some things that ought not to be in your own. Any item that you are not even aware of that has entered into your home, that has made that home to be tied in the realm of the Spirit, a cold home, let that happen. Catch fire in the realm of the Spirit. In the book of Joshua chapter 7, 11 and 12, you will see what God was telling him there. Joshua 7, 11 and 12. Some houses that are cursed, or with stolen material, building materials that they use, or stolen money or blood money that they use. And they now said, agent, please, can you help me to rent this flat, this BQ, this, but which money? Israel have sinned, and they are also transgressed by covenant, which I commanded them. For they have even taken of the accursed thing, and have also stolen, and dissembled also, and they have put it even what? Among their own stuff. Therefore, you know the reason why many people are defeated, in my monetary, financially, in their health, it could be that they are living in a cursed house. Therefore, the children of Israel could not. God was speaking, not the prophet. Stand before their enemies, but turn their backs before their enemies, because they were accursed. Neither will I be with you anymore, except what happened? He destroyed the accursed. That is the reason why God has called us today. He loves us, he wants the Lord to keep us, to keep on suffering from just praying, and we are not really seeing the full effect of our prayer. And he's looking for me, I want to hear it. Joshua was even like he tried to intimidate God. How come you said that you call on you are not even answering me because I'm praying so much prayer, I'm not even seeing it. You don't know many things. Anytime you are accusing me, I can never be wrong. Always ask me, what is it that am doing wrongly or I'm yet to do, or just show me what I need to do. And he now told him that he did not know that he can or anybody had done anything. That is the reason. I pray for you that any else that you may be living in that could be accursed one way or the other, or any item that has come into your house, maybe you did not even take it into the house, but somebody brought it from somewhere that you did not know, and it now bring a problem into your house, let the fire of God locate that item. Let the cursed spirit that has been attached to that item be banished from your home. So shall it be. However, there are some people that outwardly they need to relocate. Outwardly, God can actually bring deliverance. But some, for what one reason or the other, that I don't know why God allows that, He will just say, relocate. It happened to Abraham. Abraham, Genesis chapter 12, 1 and 2. Genesis 12, 1 and 2. Abraham, sir, live where you are. Ah, it's my family. Live where you are. If you don't live, blessing will not come, your name will not be great. But when you live, I will, because you are a blessed man in a cursed house. How do you reconcile that? Even when you are getting blessings, the blessing that you are getting is less than 30-fold. Even though you are rejoicing every day, testimony. If only you knew what you would have been getting if you are living in a blessed house. You will not be rejoicing. You will be crying. You mean I could have been getting all these things, but the prince of Persia, the forces that are in this house, they are limiting the blessing. Now the Lord has said unto Abraham, get thee out of the country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land that what? I will show thee. Two. And I will make thee. God, make me where I am. Forget, I understand why. Get thee out of that place first. And I will make thee a great nation. And I will bless thee. And make thy name great. And thou shalt be what? Be a blessing. God told me clearly this afternoon, many of my blessed children are living in cursed houses. I was such. Many of these things I've told you, I didn't know before, I didn't know them that deep. As I was telling me, well, now each point it would give me, it would now back it up to the speaker. I would now go, it's true. You give me another point. Let's check it in. It's true. So that is exactly what has been happening. Oh, there is somebody else that brought the CD into the household. But how that CD, it could be a consumer and it's affecting them, but they're not taking time. They pray for everything, but they just neglect to pray and to deliver where they are. But God, in His mercy, has designed that today we will deal with that.
Amen.
Shall we rest our feet? Let's rest our feet. Let's rest our feet. Rest our feet. When you live in a blessed house and you are a blessed person, I tell you, it will be so evident that you are a blessed person. It will be evident. People will see it clearly. They don't, you don't need to be telling them. You know, there are some people who is not until they testify. You see it clearly that this person is blessed. And by the time you are entering into a place, you know, I've not discovered that I have not even prayed effectively concerning our dedication. It's today that God made me to realize that. What the most important thing is that don't get out like that. He said that you will mention some things and not help me to prepare. I think about 34 of you have that this is just will be a typical prayer for you to be doing in the house. And when the house is blessed, it doesn't mean that it's just blessed forever like that. And I said that. Tell them that they should not be mindful of who they allow to enter and the things that they bring inside, that it will also pollute a blessed house. He was telling me that this afternoon, that even if it's a family member, let them pray and be led before whoever that comes in to stay with them will come. Let's open our mouth and pray and say, Father, thank you for this fresh insight.
Thank you.
you have given to me in order to bring deliverance to me and my family. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for this fresh insight you have given it to me in order to bring deliverance to me and my family. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. These are the prayer points that he gave me. And when he gave me, I took time to pray it inside my house. As he was giving me, I first thanked him for, God, thank you for making me to sit in the way I'm seeing it now. Then number two, say, Father, please have mercy on me. And cleanse me of all unrighteousness that could cause my prayer to be hindered. That could cause my prayer not to be answered or to be hindered. Let's pray that to be with us. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. We are come to discover or to establish that there are blessed houses and there are cursed houses. There are blessed places, there are cursed places. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, please order my step to the places of blessings and not cursed places. Always in the name of Jesus. Father, order my steps to the places of blessings and not cursed places. Always. When I'm looking for a house, let me never be led to a one that will be a cursed house. I will not be standing inside. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Jacob saw the traffic of heaven. Angels going up and down. What a good traffic. Come, I'm bringing my own blessing. Oh, let me put you down. What a good traffic. Say, Father. Please let there be positive heavenly traffic of good angels bringing blessings to my own efforts in the name of Jesus. Let there be positive heavenly traffic of good angels bringing blessings to my own henceforth. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please make the place I live a place of quick answer to prayers in the name of Jesus. They were praying for Peter. Peter was already knocking on the door. Make the place that I live a place of quick answer to our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, please clear off my home. Every prayer hindering them, and let blessing flow unto us with ease. Father, every prayer hindering them, it was hindering Daniel's prayer. Every prayer hindering them in my home, be cleared off now in the name of Jesus. And let blessing flow without hindrance into our home from now on. Thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Joseph was talking about taxing everything that was coming into their house. 20%. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, banish from my home every prosperity or power taken, or every power that is taken, or reducing my income anytime I receive it in the name of Jesus. Banish from my home every spirit of power that is taking or reducing my income anytime I receive it. Banish from my home every power that is taking or reducing my income anytime I receive it. Do some nonsense means. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. He said that it's your own, they will just be fighting. There will be faction in the home. There will be hatred. The kind of hatred that you know you won't understand. There will be the spirit that is already in that home, that they have not conducted deliverance when they don't move into that home. Say, Father, please drive out of my home right now every spirit of division, hatred, hostility, and malice in the name of Jesus. Of my own right now, every spirit of division. mighty name you have prayed. The Bible says that when the spirit leave and they find a place clean, they will not come back. So we will fill our home. Say, Father, please fill my home with your spirit of love, joy, peace, and great blessings in the name of Jesus. Father, fill my home with your spirit of love, joy, peace, and great blessings. In Jesus' name we are praying. We talk about the spirit of barrenness or anti-productivity spirit. And they now to call the man of God Elisha. He now said, it's not ordinary. And he now took Saul. And it was healed. And there was no more death. That means that there are some houses that death will always be in their finances, in their health, in their whatever. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, please drive out of my home every spirit of barrenness, sickness, miscarriage, and anti-productivity power. We demand you guys, drive it out, drive it out, drive it out. Every spirit of violence, every spirit of sickness, every spirit of anti-productivity, every spirit of miscarriage. We demand you guys. In Jesus' name, we are praying. If it is video recorder that happened to be bewitched, they will be delivered today. Yeah. If it is in doorknob that you bought, that somebody stole it and now released it to you, and somebody that it was stolen from caused that particular thing, every one of them will be delivered. Yeah. Was clothing that you bought, and a person went to steal the clothing, broke into somebody's shop, and now brought it into another city, and you now brought it, and it now becomes a cult item in your home that you use your money, it will be delivered. Yeah. Okay,
every bewitched item
in my home, bringing misfortune, sickness, or retrogression, by the power of the Most High God, be bound and cast out now in the name of Jesus. Every bewitched item that is bringing misfortune, sickness, retrogression, by the power of the Most High God, be bound and cast out. Be bound and cast out. Thank you, God. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. All these things happen in the realm of the spirit, because you may not even know which is which, but by the time you pray, God will remove them, but we are going to say that God should be replacing them with the blessed one in the realm of the spirit, so that those things will not have any mark of being caused again. Say, Father, by your outstretched hand, please remove every cause of stolen item from my home and divinely replace with blessed ones from heaven in the name of Jesus. By your outstretched hand, remove every cause item from my home and divinely replaced with the blessed one from heaven. Divinely replaced with the blessed one from heaven. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, please cleanse my own spiritually, mentally, physically, with the blood of Jesus. From the foundation to the roof, in the name of Jesus. Father, cleanse my home spiritually, mentally, physically, from the foundation to the roof, with the blood of Jesus. Cleanse my home. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, please let the fire of the Holy Spirit engulf my entire home and make it inhabitable to any unclean spirit or evil spirit in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost engulf my entire home and make my home inhabitable to any unclean spirits, any evil spirit. Let them not be able to inhabit in my home again. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please send your angels as you did in the time of the Garden of Eden to continually guard my home and keep away evil forces. Father, send your angels, as you did in the time of Garden of Eden, to continually guard my home, as you did in the time of Garden of Eden. Let them keep reading you for this. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, please convert every cursed wall or building material in my own to bless ones by your mercy and power. Every cursed wall, every cursed nail, every cursed wood, anything that they were using in the building construction that have been caused that I did not know, Father, convert them to blessed ones. Let every wall be blessed. Every item, every building item in my home, let them become blessed. Now, in Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I mentioned some of us have been contaminated by the reason of these spirits that we came to live or live with inside. I will say by the power and the blood of Jesus.
By the power of the Most High God.
By the power of the Most High God. I purify my spirit, soul, and body. And that of all members of my own with the blood of Jesus. By the power of the Most High God, I purify my spirit, soul, and body, and that of every member of my home, with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please chase out by your consuming fire every enemy residing in my home, in any realm with the immediate effect. Chase them out. Whether in the spirit, chase them out. Even if they are physical, chase them out. Every enemy. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, let every monitoring device of the kingdom of darkness planted in my home be utterly destroyed right now in the name of Jesus. Every monitoring device, even if it is a wall gecko, that is a monitoring device. If it's a cobwebs, that is the one monitoring device. And if it's a mosquito, that is any monitoring device. Stylishly put it on my own. Destroyed by fire. Thank you, brother. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, every demonic network in my own, I begin by the power of the Most High God, scatter by fire. Every demonic network in my home, scatter by fire. Every demonic network that is in my home. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, every evil altar in my home, are thwarting demonic presence, are repelling God's presence. Can fire be destroyed? Every wood altar in my home. Attracting the money present and repelling God's presence. That fire be destroyed. That fire be destroyed. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Say, by the power of the Most High God, I command all evil gates into my house to be destroyed. And the opening be sealed with the blood of Jesus. My house be destroyed. And let the opening be sealed up with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Say, I command by the power of the Most High God that every demon assigned to my home should go back to the senders and carry out the assignment with immediate effect there in the name of Jesus. Every demon will be assigned to my home. And carry out that assignment there. Carry out your assignment there. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, brother. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, please paralyze and expose every human agent of the devil in my house and flush them out with immediate effect. Every human agent. Paralyze, expose, flush out. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please take out all demons attached to any equipment or item in our home. And let those equipment become blessed. Every demon that is attached to any equipment or item, any demon attached to my kitchen utensils, attached to my TV, attached to any item in my home, flush out and let those items become blessed. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Okay, Father, please cut asunder and destroy any satanic padlock. Webs used against the prosperity and good health of anyone in the home. Father, cut asunder and destroy any satanic padlock, any cage, any webs used against the prosperity and good health of anyone in the home. Cut them asunder wherever they are. In Jesus' mercy name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please let the blood of Jesus speak to nullify any curse existing in our home. And let blessing be pronounced in the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus Christ can speak. Let the blood of Jesus Christ speak to nullify any curse that is in my home, in that place that I'm living. Let the blood of Jesus Christ speak and nullify any curse that is inside of my house. And let blessing be pronounced now. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Say, by the power of the Most High God, I remove my name and that of any member of my home from any evil register of affliction from any place right now in the name of Jesus. I remove my name and the name of any member of my home from any register of affliction. Right now I remove our names. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, by the power in the blood of Jesus, I break any satanic covenant made by the builders, landlord, or the owner of the house that I live in the name of Jesus. Every satanic covenant that has been made by my mother and my landlord, by the builders, by any owner of the property that I live, I break it, break it, break every satanic covenant of that place that I'm living. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, by the power in the blood of Jesus, I break any soul ties I or any member of my home to have with any residing demon in that home in the name of Jesus. Any soul ties I have with the residing demon in that home, or any number of my own hand, I break that soul tie now. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Number 31 out of 34. Say, Father, please release the power of resurrection on me and my family members. And let every deadness come alive gloriously. Release the power resurrection upon me and every member of my home. Let every deadness come alive now, gloriously. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Number 32 out of 34. Say, by the power of the Most High God, I command the fire of God to enter every nook and cranny of my home and destroy any charm that have been buried with immediate effect. Let the fire of God enter every nook and cranny of my home. Look at any charm that have been buried underneath the tiles, inside the wall, in the ceiling. Let the fire of God destroy every charm that have been buried in my home. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Number 32 is the Father, please bless my home. And let blessings that money can buy, and the one money cannot buy, flood my home from this moment. In the name of Jesus. Bless my home and let money, the blessings that money can buy and the money cannot buy. Flood my home from this moment. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Number 34, final, we say, Father, thank you for the mighty deliverance.